Power BI DAX Tutorial Part 2. Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are we going to learn in this video? We are going to learn and understand the different aggregate functions and different X functions such as sum, average, count, MINX, MAXX, COUNTA, COUNTX, Distinctcount, and different applications of it. So by the end of this video, you could get a very clear idea. So how to use the different X functions, distinct functions, and as well as the aggregate functions. So watch till the end. So my dear viewers, in the previous part of Power BI DAX tutorial, we have learned different date and time functions. So today we are going to learn different aggregate functions, and added on to that aggregate functions, we are going to see the X functions and distinct functions. So here, if you see on the screen, we have the column called sales, we have the column called quantity, we have the column called discount, and we have the column called profit. Okay, so if I would like to see how much is my total sales, that's where we use the DAX function called sum. So what I'm doing here, I'm choosing a new measure. In the previous part one of our DAX tutorial, we have all used new column. So now we will use new measure where we are going and doing some calculation of aggregate data. So here I would like to calculate my sum, or I could calculate the column name as total sales equal to sum of, what is the column that we have under orders table? Sales column, am I right? Under orders table, sales column. So this is what I would like to see it in the output. So sum of orders of sales, that's where I'll get my total sales. So if we just have a verification for this, I'll take a cart chart, and in this cart chart, let us go and get my total sales that we have calculated just now. So total sales, so my total sales is 2.30 million. So that's how you can use this sum function in order to find out the total. All right, so we have got this one, but how should we even find out the average? What is my average sales? So we have to find average. So in order to find average, the DAX function that we use is average itself. So let us find it out. So what I'm doing it here, again, I'm choosing a new measure. And this new measure where we are going to find out the average sales. So average sales equal to average itself is the DAX function. All right. So I'm clicking on average, and what is the column name? Average of sales. Sales column under which table? Orders table. So let me click on enter. So when I see here, so we have calculated average sales. So let's go and cross verify it. So for this, what I'm doing, I'm choosing a cart chart. And in this cart chart, let me find the average sales that we have calculated. So the average sales that we have calculated is 229.86. This is my average sales. Okay, so now there is one another way to find it out. So for that, what I'm doing, I'm just choosing the cart chart. And in this cart chart, the sales column that we have, original column that we have it in our data, that I'm getting it here. Okay, so now in this what I'm doing, as soon as you click on right click, we'll get sum, average, and all this. So if I click on average, directly you are getting the value 229.86. So as you can see, it's correct. So we have done through DAX, and we have generally done with the interface. So that's where we are getting the right value. Okay, so we have seen sum and we have seen average. Now let's go and see how many products we have. Okay, how many different products we have in our particular table. So for that, what I'm doing, again, I'm choosing a new measure. So in this new measure, I would like to see how many total products I have. Okay, now if I see that, let me go with the number. I would like to see the number. So product count, okay, product count equal to, so count is the DAX function that I'm choosing it here. When I click on this count, it is asking me the column name. It counts the numbers in a column. So let me go on, click on product ID. Okay, so let me click on enter. So I will use the cart chart here. In this cart chart, let me go and get the product name that we have found out just now, product count. So if I'm getting it here, we can see that 9994 is my product count. So is this true? So for that, what I'm doing, we should not believe directly by using count. The reason is that count will also consider the repeated values, you know? So we need to get the right answer, right number, right? So for that, we will use another DAX function called a distinct count. What this distinct count is doing, it will eliminate the repeated values and it will consider only the unique values. Okay, it will consider only the unique values. So for this, what I'm doing, I'm going and choosing a new measure. So in this new measure, what I'm doing, I am just writing the name as distinct count of products. Okay, so for this, what I am doing, I am choosing the DAX function called distinct count, and it counts the number of distinct values in a column. So what is the column name? Column name is product ID, which is in the orders table. Let me click on enter. So we have got the distinct count answer. So let's verify it. So for that, I am just clicking on a card chart and I am seeing here the distinct count that we have calculated just now, distinct count of product names. So 1862. So my dear viewers, if you carefully, you know, see the difference, we generally have 1862 products, but these 1862 products were repeated. So count is giving us 9994, the repeated values answer, but 1862 is the right answer, the distinct count that we have it of our products. So that is a very interesting difference. All right. So now, if you would like to find out the lowest value, okay, from an expression, for each row, from an expression, if you find out the lowest value, so how should we do that? So for that, what I'm doing, I'm going and choosing a new measure here, and here I'm choosing the DAX function called MINX equal to. So what this MINX is doing, it will return the smallest numerical value from an evaluating an expression for each row of a table. So what is the table name? Table name is orders, comma. So now what is the expression? So if I would like to consider the sales. So for example, there is a pen and I have purchased 5 pens. So 1 into 5, the quantity. So that's what I would like to consider it here. So sales column into multiply by, okay, then the another column called quantity. Okay, another column called quantity. So these two I am considering it. So now if you are getting a doubt, okay, whether if I might have applied some filter for this one, you could also use the function called filter here. You could also use the function called filter here in order to get the appropriate and right results. Okay, so now, so what I have done here, I have considered sales multiplied by quantity. This is an expression I'm choosing it. So from which table I'm choosing this one? From orders table. So now what I'm doing, if I click on enter, it will see the minimum, the lowest value, from the lowest value from the expression that we have calculated. So for this, I'm choosing a card chart to check out the value and I'm getting the minimum X. The answer is 0.44. Okay. So that is the minimum sales that we have it in our data set. So now what I'm going to do, I'm just going here in a table view, I'll show you the orders, and if I show you the sales column that we have, and as you can see that 0.44 is the least one, right? So this is what the right result we have got. Okay, so now in the same way, if I would like to go and find out the MAXX as well, so for this what I'm doing, just you can click on new measure. And here I'm giving MAXX equal to MAXX of, so what is the table name? Table name is orders, and the same expression I'm going to take, which is order of sales, you know, multiply by order of quantity. Okay, you could even use filter function in this particular MAXX, you know, so that if you have applied any filter, so that will be removed. Okay, so I have clicked on MAXX. So now I'll take a card chart. Okay, I'll go with the MAXX. So we have got 135.83k, which is the highest value which we have, which is the highest value. So we have seen MINX, we have seen MAXX. Now let us find out using COUNTA function. What this COUNTA function does is that it will count the number of rows that contain a non-blank values. So let's find out this COUNTA DAX function. So here again I'm choosing a new measure. So you can click new measure like this, or you can right click here and, you know, click on new measure. It's up to you. So now I'm choosing the count a DAX function. So here I'm choosing count a, so which we have it here. So in this count a, what I'm going to do, I'm choosing the column name. So we have various columns here. So let us consider the product ID column again. So orders of product ID column, it will count and give me the value. Okay, so let's go and check it out if it is a non-blank values. So now I'm choosing a card chart here, and in this card chart I'm getting this count a function that we have calculated, 9994. Okay, as there are no blank and all, so we are getting the exact answer. Okay, so now we have seen count a. In the same way of count a, we also have another DAX function called count x that also comes under the x functions, expression functions. So let us find out that count x function. So for this, what I'm doing, I'm clicking on new measure and I'm going and choosing the name as count x, and here I'm choosing the DAX function called count x. So what exactly is this count x doing? It counts the number of values which results from evaluating an expression from of each row of a table. So what is the table name? First we will go with the orders name. So here we are giving the expression. So what I'm doing here, order of sales multiply by order of quantity. Okay, if I do like this, now if I just click on enter, so let's verify this result. So here what I'm doing, taking a card chart again, and I'll get this count x value. So we can see 9994 again. So why are we getting the same answers here? So here we don't have any blank information. Okay, we don't have any empty cells. The data that we are using is 100% clean. Okay, so if there are some disturbances in the data, some null values, some empty cells, then you might face the different answers or different values for each of these things. So in the same way, we have different other x functions as well, such as count ax, product x. So I'm just leaving it to you for a better practice, and all these we have learned with some few examples. So in this video, we have seen the different functions, how to use it, different X functions, aggregate functions, and distinct functions. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.